Masurika, Romantika, and Vispoda. If we go through Madhavanadana, there are few diseases, especially eruptive diseases, explained after the chapter of Visarpa. So the chronology is maintained in such a way that most of these diseases have manifestations similar to that of Visarpa, and even management principles are also similar to that of Visarpa. That is why these diseases are told together. So if you go through the current practice, we get a lot of patients with measles and chickenpox in our practice, and there is also smallpox which has been already eradicated. So these disorders can be considered with the modern counterparts as chickenpox, smallpox, as well as Masurika. So let us look into Masurika first. So the Pratyatma Lakshana of Masurika itself is Masura Agriti Samsthana Pidagasur Masurika. So the eruptions will be similar to that of the Masura. So that is a Masura Agriti Samsthana Pidagasu Masurika. Let us look at the Nidana. Kattumla Levanakshara Virudha Dhyashanasanehi Dushta Nishpava Shagadehi Pradushta Pavanodagehi Krura Grahekshanachavi Deshe Dosha Samudhada Janendi Sharire Asmin Dushta Raktena Sangada Masura Agriti Samsthana Pidagasur Masurika. So obviously, there are dietary causes, lifestyle causes, as far as there are external causes too, like Pradushta, Pavana and Udaga. So that we know that all these eruptive fevers happens whenever there is a spread, a local spread. So that is why this Pradushta, Pavana, Udaga is told here. Krura Graheshana, just as the time is bad. And Deshe Dosha Samuddhada. So whenever there is a eruptive disease going on in the particular desha, then the people are susceptible to get this infection. And pitta rakta dushtigara aharas like katu amla lavana kshara viruddha adhyasana and even anashana is told as a nidana. Maybe all these internal factors, that means dietary factors, makes the person more susceptible. And when the there is vitiation in the desha or air or water, leads to the manifestation of the disease. The Samprapti in Madhugosha is explained as Pittam Shonita Samsrishtam Yada Doshedi Twajam. So that the main culprit is Pitta and the Dosha is Rekta. Tada Karodi Pidagaha Sarva Gatreshu Dehinam. So that it produces Pidaga in all over the body. And also he tells about the different size or shapes of these pidagas or eruptions, like Masura, Mudga, Masha, Kola, etc. So that is why it's a basically a disease which is Pitta Raktadiga. Purarupa is explained as Tasam Puram Jwaraha Kandur Gatra Bhango Aradir Brahmaha. So there is prodromal fever, itching, pain. Gatra Bhanga is pain. Aradi is restlessness, Brahma is giddiness. Toji Shodha Savaivarnyo. Swellings, these are localized. Netra Ragascha. So there is conjunctival injection as well. Next, going into the each dosha lakshanas. Vadaja, Spota, Shavaruna, Ruksha, Tivra Vedanaya, Anvida, Kadina, Chirapagascha, Bhavandi, Anilasambhavaha. So that there is Shava, Aruna, Spoda, it's Ruksha, then Tivra Vedana, Kadina, Chirapagasha, it takes more time to get Paga. Then there is Sandhi Asti Parvanam, Bhedaha, pain in the joints, especially the small joints and bone, Kasaha, cough, Kamba, tremor, Aradi, restlessness, Klama, again tiredness, Shoshaha, Talu, Oshta, Jihvana. So dryness in the talu, oshta, jihva, trishna is thirst and aruji. So these are the lakshanas when there is vada predominance. Next is when there is pitta predominance, the lesions will be rakta, pita, asita, off whitish. Sadaha, tivra vedana, again tivra vedana and burning sensation. And ajirapagascha, pitta gova samudbhava. Ajirapaga means the paga happens very fast compared to vada, where it's told that the paga happens only very slowly. But here, since this is pittaja, it is achira paga. And also there are constitutional features like vidbheda, so there is adhisara, then angamarda, daha, trishna, aruji, mukha paga, akshira agascha, jwaraha, tivraha. Compared to the vadaja, the jwara will be more severe. Next is kafaja, kapha prasega, staimityam, shiroru, gatra gaurav. So these are constitutional features. There is kapha prasega, excessive salivation, staimitya, a feeling of as if it's coated, body is coated. Siroruk, gatra gauravam, heaviness, hrillasa, nausea, aruji, nidra, tandra, alasya. So that there is laziness, sleepiness, or even drowsiness. The lesions will be shweda, snigdha, then stula, that is more bulkier than the that is found in pittaja and vadaja. Ichi, kandura, manda vedana, the pain will be less compared to pitta and vada. And it is again chirapaga. Next is raktaja. The raktaja also, the lakshanas are same like as if in pittaja. Next is sannipadaja. Neela, chipitiga, vistirna, madhye nimna, maharuja. So that the lesion is bluish, it's more flattened, and there is madhya nimnada, so that it's more sunken in the middle. And maharuja, chirapaga, again takes more time for paga. Pudisravaha, so that there is a purulent discharge from the lesion, it is sarvadoshaja. And constitutional features like kandharodha, aruji, stambha, pralaba, aradhi samyudaha, duschigilsyaha. So that this is more difficult to treat. So next is romantika. The reference contains only two lines loga. So we have to infer that almost all the other lakshanas, including the prodrome, are similar to that is found in masurika, except that the lesions are roma kubo nadisama. So that just like when the hair follicles are elevated, so that these lesions are more smaller than that what is found in masurika. So roma kubo nadisama, raginya, kapha pittajaha, kasa arojaka samyukta, romandyo, jwarapurvikaha. So that there are constitutional features like kasa, arojaka, and jwara. And the lesions, the disease is predominantly kapha pittaja in nature. So this is romandika. It's again a eruptive fever because there is jwara as a prodrome. The sadhya sadhita is told together for romandika and masurika. Mainly we have to consider this sadhya sadhita for masurika. Vadaja, vada pittotha, sleshma vada kridashaya, krichra sadhitama, tasmat yatna deda upajare. So vadaja, vada pittaja, and sleshma vadaja are krichra sadhya. Sannibada is asadhya, and the lakshanas are again told as pravala sadrisha kaschit, kaschit jambu phalobama, lohajala sama kaschit, adasi phala sanniba. So that different sizes and like pravala, jambu phala, etc. Asam bahuvida varna jayande dosha bhedada. So this is regarding sadhya sadhita of masurika and romandika. And also acharya has told that which all patients we have to avoid treating. So the constitutional features like kasa, hikka, prameha, tivra jwara, pralaba, aradi, murcha, loss of consciousness, trishna, daho, adigurna daha, mughena, prasraved raktam. So that there is hemorrhagic manifestations from mouth, nose or eyes. Kandhe gurguragam kritva, shusitya atyartha vedanam. So that there is shwasa and there is severe pain. Masurika abhibodhasya, yasya idani bishagvarehi, lakshanani chadrishyande, na didya tatra beshjav. So these are mostly found in case of complications. There can be neurological as well as hemorrhagic complications of these eruptive fevers, especially in case of viral eruptive fevers. So these lakshanas have some similarities to what we find now in the modern textbooks regarding the neurological as well as hemorrhagic complications of the viral eruptive fevers. So if such lakshanas are found, we should not treat the patient. Next is Vispoda. This is again, it's told as a separate chapter immediately after the Visarpa Adhikara. The Nidanas are told as Katu Amla Tikshnoshna Vidahi Ruksha Kshare Rajirna Adhyasana Adhapesha Tadartu Doshena. So that Rudu Dosha Vibariyena Kupyandi Doshaha Pavanadestu Twaja Masrityate Rakta Mamsastini Pradushyaja Khoran Kurvandi Vispodan Sarvan Jwara Purasaran. So this has more deeper dhatu involvement in the form of mamsa and asti. But in case of Raumandika and Masurika, only rakta has been implied. Again, the nidanas are similar. Again, rudu dosha is also one of the nidanas. So this also can be considered as a, what you call as an eruptive fever, which occurs in the form of a outbreak, disease outbreak. So the typical lakshanas are agni, dagda, nibhaspotaha. So these are vesicular lesions. Whereas Masurika and Raumandika, they are not vesicular lesions, but these are vesicular lesions. That is why Agni Dagdha Nibha, as if we get a vesicle immediately after a burn. Similarly, the lesions will be there. And also there is Sajjwara Rakta Pitta Jaha. Mainly the main doshas are Rakta and Pitta itself. There is Sajjwara, so there is fever. Kojit Sarvatra Vadehe, either it is localized or it is widely distributed. So this is the Pratyatma Lakshana of Vispoda. And again, Egadoshaja, Dundaja and Tridoshaja are explained. In case of Egadoshaja, in Vadaja, Shiroruk, Shola Bhuishtam, Jura, Trit, Parva Bhedanam, Sakrishna Varnada Chedi, Vada Vispoda, Lakshanam. In Pittaja, Jura, Daha, Ruja, Srava, Paga, Trishna Bhiranvidam, Pida Lohida Varnamcha, Pitta Vispoda, Lakshanam. In Kavaja, Chardi, Arojaga, Jadiani, Kandu, Kadinya Panduda, Avedana, Chirat Pagi, Savispoda, Kafatmaga. In Vada Pittaja, Vada Pitta Grudoyastu, Kurude, Tivra Vedanam. So the combined lakshanas will be there. Along with that, there is Tivra Vedana. In case of Kafavadaja, Kandu, Staimitya, Gurubir, Janiya, Kafavadaja. And in Kapha Pittaja, Kandur, Daho, Jura, Chardi, in Kapha Pittaja. In case of Tridoshaja, Madhye, Nimno, Nado, Ande. So there is Nimnada in the Madhya and Unnada in the Anda. Kadhino, Alpa, Prabhagavan. The Paga is very slow. Daha, Raga, Trisha, Moha, Chardi, Murcha, Ruja, Jura. Pralabo, Vevadu, Tandra, so Asadhyasya, Tridoshaja. So Tridoshaja is basically Asadhya. And Rektaja is also explained. Rekta, Rekta Samuttana, Gunja Vidruma Sanniba. It is just like the Gunja. Vedidavyastu Rektena, Paitigena cha Heduna. So it will have similar lakshanas of the Pittaja. And this is Nate, Siddhim, Samayandi. This is Asadhya. And in case of other doshas, Ego doshotida sadhya, krichra sadhya, dvidoshaja, sarva doshotido, ghorastu asadhyo. So, ega doshaja, vispoda is sadhya, dvidoshaja or dundvaja is krichra sadhya, and tridoshaja is asadhya. So, that is regarding Masurika, Raumandika, and Vispoda. So, the modern counterparts, we can consider it as smallpox, chickenpox, measles, and also there are other eruptive fevers like rubella, etc. So there is no use of doing an exact one-to-one correlation because if you go through some of the textbooks, Masurika is compared to smallpox, and some others call chickenpox as Kshudra Masurika or Laghu Masurika, of which actual references are not available. But if you go through the lesions, actually Vispoda is Agni Dagdha Nibhaspoda, and we know that in chickenpox it's just like vesicular lesions are more predominant, but not in case of measles or rubella, where the lesions are more of papular. So we can consider chickenpox under the concept of Vispoda. Vispoda also can be considered as herpes zoster when it is localized. It's not one-on-one correlation, but just if you want to correlate, we can correlate it like that. Smallpox is already been eradicated, so we are not going to discuss about smallpox. The next part of this class is going to deal with the chickenpox and measles. So chickenpox, it's largely a childhood disease, and it's caused by varicella zoster virus, and it's a double-stranded DNA virus. The transmission occurs through inhalation of the airborne respiratory droplets or droplet infection, which is put out by the infected host. And also transmissions can happen through direct contact with the vesicles or the fluid from the vesicles. But this is a rare mode. Usually it's transmitted by respiratory droplets. And the patient can start spreading the disease immediately 1 to 2 days before the onset of the rash as well. The incubation period is around 10 to 21 days. And the features include, usually there are no prodromes as we see in measles, but some individuals, especially adults, can have a prodrome of nausea, myalgia or body ache, muscle pain, anorexia and headache. There are some patients who report severe back pain as well immediately preceding the eruption. Then the patient will be infectious 1 to 2 days prior to the development of the rash. And the rash usually starts as a small erythematous macules, especially on the scalp, face and trunk and proximal limbs. Then it sequentially progresses into papules and clear vesicles, and later on pustules, and subsequent central umbilication and crust formation. And usually this process takes around 12 to 14 hours. And the vesicles may also appear on the palms, soles and even the mucous membranes. And this can also occur in the oropharyngeal or urogenital areas. And usually after some 1 or 2 days, intense pruritus or itching can start. Usually it follows the vesicular stage of the rash. And the patient remains infectious for 4 to 5 days after the development of the rash. And especially by the time when the last crop of vesicles have usually crusted over. And typically the vesicle is surrounded by erythematous halo and is described as a dewdrop on a rose petal. And usually the disease is characterized by different lesions in different parts of the body, so that there will be transforming lesions in different parts of the body. So there can be an active as well as healing lesions, so that we can see rashes in all stages of its development in the body parts. There are complications in kids or in children. The complications are very less, and it usually goes off as a very mild febrile eruptive fever or eruptive illness. But in case of adults or adolescents, someone can land in complications, commonest one being pneumonia. And also secondary bacterial infections can happen to the lesions. Septicemia has also been reported. And in severe cases, central nervous system complications like Reye syndrome, Guillain-Barré syndrome, acute cerebellar ataxia, and encephalitis have been reported. There are also chances of hemorrhagic complications in the terms of thrombocytopenia and the resultant purpura. And usually these are common in immunocompromised or immunosuppressed individuals. Investigations, usually it doesn't need an investigation unless we are in the initial part of an outbreak where the illness is not properly known. But usually the diagnosis is clinical, and there are also other techniques like sang smear or the culturing the vesicular fluid for extracting the virus, serological testing for identifying the antigen or the antibody, chest radiography can be done in case of suspected case of pneumonia, and histological examination of the lesions. A sang smear is usually prepared. It can be prepared in an office setting. It's prepared out of the vesicular fluid, and it demonstrates multinucleated giant cells and epithelial cells with eosinophilic intranuclear inclusion bodies. Next is regarding measles. Measles is also known as rubeola. It's one of the most contagious infectious diseases. We all know that kids are usually frequently vaccinated. Measles, mumps and rubella vaccines. And the measles have a 90% secondary infection rate. It's usually a disease of childhood, but can affect people of all ages. Regarding the agent, the virus is a single-stranded RNA virus called the measles virus. It's transmitted by respiratory droplets, and it's usually spread by coughing or sneezing via close personal contact or direct contact with the secretions. An incubation period, it's lesser than that of chickenpox. It usually ranges from 7 to 14 days. The clinical features include, there will be a prodromal phase, which includes a fever, which is usually high, and it lasts around 4 to 7 days. And also there will be malaise and anorexia. And there is a classic triad explained in terms of conjunctivitis, cough, and coryza. The characteristic enanthem. Enanthem means there are two terms, enanthem and exanthem. Enanthem is internal eruptions, and it usually appears 2 to 4 days after the onset of the prodrome. And small spots in the form of coplic spots can be seen inside the cheeks during this early stage. So this is typically diagnostic of an oncoming measles. So this is a coplic spot. These tiny white spots, these are called as coplic spots, and this is usually happens as a prodrome of measles. And the typical eruption or the exanthem usually appears 1 to 2 days after the appearance of the coplic spots. It starts on the face and the upper neck and then spreads to the extremities. There will be mild pruritus. And usually the uncomplicated measles, it can run from 7 to 10 days. And cough may be the final symptom that can appear. And just like the chickenpox, there can be complications in measles. And usually it's more likely to occur in kids younger than 5 years or older, adults older than 20 years. Complications include pneumonia, otitis media, interstitial pneumonitis, bronchopneumonia, laryngeotracheobronchitis, encephalomyelitis, diarrhea, sinusitis, subclinical hepatitis, lymphadenitis, intravascular coagulation in the form of DIZ, and subacute sclerosing panencephalitis. This SSPE has been reported in kids. Investigations include, again, it's of clinical diagnosis. In most scenarios, it can be diagnosed clinically. But serological testing for immunoglobulins, that is antibodies, IgG and IgM, can be done. RT-PCR tests can be done to identify the virus. Complete blood count may indicate leukopenia with relative lymphocytosis and thrombocytopenia. And LFT, in case of subclinical hepatitis, LFT can be deranged in the form of elevated transaminase levels. So that is regarding chickenpox and measles.